Today's video session of relations, we will learn about the remaining properties of relations, that is binary relation. In last session, we have learned three properties of relations, that is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. In this session, we will learn about irreflexive relation, asymmetric relation and antisymmetric relation. So let us start with today's first property, that is irreflexive relation. So in order to be a relation R, to be irreflexive, we should not have any ordered pair of type x comma x belongs to R. For all elements, x belongs to A. In other words, we can say that there should be no reflexive ordered pair present in that particular relation R to be irreflexive. So let us say one example. If we are having a set A containing elements 1, 2 and 3 and then we are having a relation R1 containing ordered pairs 1, 1, 2, 2 and 2, 3 depend on set A. So the question is R1 irreflexive? Now the answer is no. Why? Because here we are having the ordered pairs of type 1, 1, 2, 2. That means we are having the ordered pairs of type x, x, and those type of ordered pairs are not allowed in irreflexive relations. So that's why this relation R1 is not reflexive. Some more examples. So the relation phi, that is empty relation, it is irreflexive? Yes. The type of relation less than, greater than, all these are reflexive. But the relation of type delta, delta means equality relation. So equality relation, universal relation, relation of less than equal to, greater than equal to, divides and multiple of, all these relations are not irreflexive. So now let us see how we can represent irreflexive relations in matrix and graph. So if we want to find through a matrix that whether a given relation is irreflexive or not, then all the diagonal elements of matrix should be equal to 0. That means no ordered pairs of type x, x should be present in that relation. And similarly, if we want to find out the irreflexive relation from the graph, then in that particular graph, there should be no self loop on any of the nodes present there in that graph. So for example, if we are having an element x in the graph, then there should be no self loop on that particular node, let us say x. Similarly, if there are other elements present there, then there should not be any self loop in those nodes. So let us see another property, that is asymmetric relations. So if we are having a relation R on a set A, then that relation R is said to be asymmetric if we are having an ordered pair x, y belongs to R, then we should not have an ordered pair y, x belongs to R. That means if x, y is present there, y, x should not be present there for a relation to be asymmetric. Even the types of ordered pairs x, x should not be present there for a relation to be asymmetric. Let us see some examples of it. So suppose we are having a relation R2 on a given set A, and that relation R2 has ordered pair 1, 2. So now the question is R2 asymmetric? Yes, because we are having here an ordered pair of type x, y, but we are not having here any ordered pair of type y, x. So that means it is asymmetric. Another example. So let us say that we are again having another relation R3 defined on the same set A, and this relation R3 is containing the ordered pairs 1, 3, 3, 1 and 2, 3. Now the question is again the same, is R3 asymmetric? So here we can see that we are having a pair of type x, y, that is 1, 3. Then we are having 3, 1. That means we are also having the pair of type y, x here. So here x, y is present. Also y, x is present here. That is not possible in the asymmetric relation according to the definition of asymmetric relation. So that's why this relation R3 is not asymmetric. Another example, relationship of type 5, less than and greater than, all these are asymmetric. And the relationship of type universal relation, less than equal to, greater than equal to, divides and multiple of, all these relations are not asymmetric. So now let us see how we can represent asymmetric relations in graph. So obviously, if we are having x comma y and h with x is not equal to y, because self loops are also not allowed in asymmetric relation. So if this type of edge is there, then the type of edge, that is y comma x, should not be there, and also there must be no self loop. So if we represent it with nodes x and y, edge from x to y, then there should not be an edge from y to x. That means this type of arc, this type of edge should not be there for a relation to be asymmetric, along with the type of self loops. That means an ordered pair of type x comma x or y comma y should not be present there in that particular relation to be symmetric. So let us move on to the next property, that is anti-symmetric relations. So if we are having a relation R on a given set A, then for a relation R to be anti-symmetric, there must be an ordered pair x comma y belongs to R, and if again we are having an ordered pair of type y comma x, then x equal to y, otherwise it is not anti-symmetric. So let us see it with an example. So let us say that we are having again the same set A here, and we are having a relation R1 defined as 1 comma 2, 2 comma 1 and 2 comma 3. So the question is again the same, that is R1 anti-symmetric. We can see that here we are having an ordered pair 1 comma 2 and 2 comma 1. Then here we are having x comma y and also y comma x, and in these two ordered pairs, that is 1 comma 2 and 2 comma 1, 1 is not equal to 2. That means if for x comma y and y comma x, we are not having x equal to y. So that means it is not anti-symmetric. So the answer is no. Another example. So the relationship of type phi delta, less than, greater than, less than equal to, greater than equal to, divides and multiple of, all these are anti-symmetric. But the relationship of a type A cross A, that is universal relation, it is not anti-symmetric, because it will also contain the type of pairs x comma y as well as y comma x. So one more thing, that if x is not equal to y, then if x comma y is present, then y comma x should not be present there. So we can see it also in this way. Now let us see how we can represent anti-symmetric relations in matrix and graph. So if R is an anti-symmetric relation, then it matrix, if Mij equal to 0, then Mji equal to 0 whenever I is not equal to j. So we can represent it like this. And for graph, if xy is an edge with x is not equal to y, then y comma x should not be an edge there in the graph. That means if we are having two nodes x and y, and we are having an edge from x to y, then the edge from y to x should not be there. But the self loops can be there. That means the ordered pairs of the type x comma x or y comma y can be there in this type of graph where the relation is anti-symmetric. So let us see one example. So if we are having this relationship defined on set A equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. So is it reflexive? No, because all the nodes are not having self loops. Is it symmetric? No, because here we are having the ordered pair 1, 2, but not 2, 1. So that means it is not symmetric. Transitive? No, because we are having an edge from 1 to 2 and 2 to 4. So there must be an edge from 1 to 4, but it is not present here. So it is not transitive. Irreflexive? No, because we are having a self loop on one node, so it is not irreflexive. Antisymmetric, no, because we are having an edge from 2 to 4 and also an edge from 4 to 2, where 2 is not equal to 4, so it is not antisymmetric even. And for asymmetric, again the answer is no, because again we are having the type of pair 2,4 and 4,2. All the pair of type 1,1 is not allowed here, so it is not asymmetric. Now we will see some points that can be useful. So the first point, that there can be a relation which is neither reflexive nor irreflexive. So the example is this, that is a relation. If we define a relation R3 here on a set A, so it is 1,1, 2,2, 2,3. So here we are not having all the ordered pairs of type x, x, so it is not reflexive. But here we are having two ordered pairs which are of type x, x, so it is neither irreflexive. Another point, there can be a relation which is both symmetric and antisymmetric. So let us see again an example. So this is relation R4, 1,1, 2,2 and 3,3. This is obviously the equality relation, and this relation is symmetric as well as antisymmetric, because in antisymmetric relation loops are allowed. Another point, there can be a relation which is neither symmetric nor antisymmetric. So if we define a relation R5, that is 1,2, 2,3 and 3,2. So we can see that we are having an ordered pair of type 1,2, but 2,1 is not present there, so it is not symmetric. But here we are having an ordered pair 2,3. Similarly, we are having an ordered pair 3,2, so it is not antisymmetric either. So that means it is neither symmetric nor antisymmetric. Another point, that every asymmetric relation is antisymmetric, but every antisymmetric relation need not be asymmetric. We will see it with an example. So suppose we are having a relation R6 containing ordered pair 1,2. So 1,2, it is both antisymmetric and asymmetric. But again, if we are having another relation R7 containing ordered pair 1,1 and 1,2, so here it is antisymmetric, because in antisymmetric self loops are allowed, and we are not having ordered pair y, x, whenever we are having an ordered pair of x, y, so it is antisymmetric, but it is not asymmetric, because in asymmetric even self loops are not allowed. So it is antisymmetric but not asymmetric. So now some questions. So the first question is, how many number of reflexive relations are there on set A having n elements? The answer is 2^n, n-1. You can solve it in the similar way with which we have solved the number of relation for reflexive property. So I am leaving this as an exercise for all of you. Another question, how many number of asymmetric relations are there on set A having n elements? The answer is 3^n, n-1/2. And how many number of relations that are asymmetric defined on a set A having n elements? The answer is 2^n into 3^n, n-1/2. So for all this, I am leaving this as an example to solve all these. So that was all for today's session. In the next session, we will learn about the inverse and complementary relations. Thank you.